हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टुडे रिलेशंस एंड फंक्शंस चैप्टर नंबर 1 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी क्लास 12 मैथमेटिक्स। और रिलेशंस वी हैव स्टडीड इन 11th स्टैंडर्ड। ओके, सो लेट अस हैव अ रिवीजन बिफोर वी नो व्हाट इज अ रिलेशन। यू मस्ट बी वेल अवेयर ऑफ कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट्स। ओके, सपोज वी हैव टू टेक द कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ टू सेट्स ए एंड बी। ओके, देन वी कैन डिफाइन द कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू सेट्स ए एंड बी एज अ सेट कंटेनिंग ऑल द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर्स ए कॉमा बी सच दैट ए बिलोंग्स टू सेट ए एंड बी बिलोंग्स टू सेट बी। सो कार्टेशियन प्रोडक्ट ऑफ टू सेट्स ए एंड बी इज अ सेट कंटेनिंग ऑल द ऑर्डर्ड पेयर्स ए कॉमा बी सच दैट A belongs to set A and B belongs to set B. For example, suppose if we have in set A 1, 2 and in set B we have A, B, then A cross B or A by B can be written as 1A, 1B, then 2A and 2B. Okay, this is the Cartesian product A by B. If you reverse the order, then you will have the Cartesian product B by A. Clear? So B by A will give you A, B, A, 2. That is B by A. The number of elements in A by B is given by M by N, where M is the number of elements present in set A and N is the number of elements present in set B. So here in set A we have two elements, value of M is 2. In set B we have two elements, value of N is also 2. So 2 into 2, 2 to the 4. So we have 4 ordered pairs in A by B. Clear? Now similarly, suppose you have to find on a single set, suppose that A is given and we need to find the cross product A by B, A by A. Then how you are going to find A by A? 1, 2 by 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1 and 2, 2. This is A by A, and the number of elements in A by A, N of A by A is given by N square or 2 into 2, that is 2 square, yes or no? So N square is the formula, that is 2 square is equal to 4. Clear? So now you have understood both A by B and A by A. Now we can define relation. Okay, now let us see what is the relation. The relation from set A to set B and from set A to itself we will see. Now first we will see what is the relation from set A to set B. So a relation from set A to set B is a subset of A by B. Okay, a relation from set A to set B is a subset of A by B. Clear? Now we know that what is the, how to find the subset or what is the number of subset of on any set. In 11th standard, in chapter number 1, set theory, we have seen the formula of finding the number of subsets. What is that formula? That is 2 raised to n. Number of subsets is calculated using the formula 2 raised to n, where n is the number of elements present in a given set. So suppose set A has n elements, then the number of subsets in set A will be 2 raised to n. Suppose if set A has 2 elements, then the number of subsets will be 2 raised to 2, that will be equal to 4. Now we have to find the number of subsets of A by B. So what is the, what is n of a by b? We know that n of a by b is m by n, where m is equal to n of a and n is equal to n of b. Number of elements in set A is m and number of elements in set B is denoted by n. So n of a by b is m cross n, and therefore number of relations will be given by the formula 2^2 m by n. So we can use this formula to calculate the number of relations from set A to set B. Clear? We can see one example. Suppose if set A has two elements, if n of A is equal to m is equal to 2 and n of B is equal to n is equal to 3, then n of A by B is equal to 2 by 3 is equal to 6, and therefore number of relations from set A to set B will be 2^2 m by n, that is equal to 2^6. Clear? So there will be total 64 relations defined from set A to set B. Okay, now I hope you have understood these terms. Now let us move further. Let us see the relation from set A to itself. Okay, now relation on a set. A relation on a set A is a subset of A by A. Just like a relation from set A to set B is a subset of A by B, in the same way, relation on a set A or a relation from set A to itself is a subset of A by A. So if set A has two elements, then the number of here n of A denoted by n only is equal to 3, then the number of relations on set A will be given by the formula 2^n². Okay, so here 2^n², that is 3², so 2^9. So how many relations will be possible from set A to itself? 2^9 relations. Clear? So relation on set A is important. A relation on set A means a relation from set A to itself. It means it is a subset of A by A. Remember this thing. Okay, now let us see the types of relation. On a set. In this we will see the first type, that is empty relation Okay. We know that empty set is a subset of A by A. Yes or no? We know that empty set is a subset of every set, and therefore empty set is a subset of A by A. Because what is relation on set A? That is a subset of A by A, and empty set is a subset of A by A, and therefore this is a relation from on set A, or it is a relation from set A to itself, we can say. And therefore empty set is a relation on set A. Okay, in other words, we can define, in other words, empty, what is an empty relation? So a given relation is empty on set A if no element of set A is related to any element of set A. In other words, a relation on set A is an empty relation if no element of set A is related to any element of set A. Clear? This is simple definition, you can understand. Now let us see the example. We will try to understand this definition with the help of an example. What is an empty relation? Let us take one example of an empty relation. Let set A contains 3 elements 1, 2 and 3. Okay, and I define a relation R by a set of all the ordered pairs A, comma B such that A plus B is greater than 5. Clear? A plus B is greater than 5. This is the condition, and A, B belongs to set A. Now let us find out. Okay, now let us recall the definition of a relation. What is the relation? A relation is a subset of A by A. So here, how many ordered pairs will be there in A by A? We know that there are 9 ordered pairs. Which are the 9 ordered pairs? Let me write down in order to explain this. Okay, the 9 ordered pairs will be 1-1, 1-2, 1-3, then 2-1, 2-2, 2-3, then 3-1, 3-2, 3-3. So we have 1-1, 1-2, 1-3, 2-1, 2-2, 2-3 and 3-1, 3-2, 3-3. Okay, now it is very important for you to understand this definition of a relation. Actually, we know that the relation is a subset of A by A. Now you have all the ordered pairs, 9 ordered pairs of A by A. So relation will be containing some or all the ordered pairs of A by A. Yes or no? This is A by A. Relation will contain the ordered pairs from this set A by A. Now which ordered pairs it will contain? Only those ordered pairs which satisfy the given condition. Okay, so let us try and check each and every ordered pair and find out which ordered pair satisfy this condition. Let us take the first ordered pair 1 and 1. Here first element will no. So this ordered pair will not come. Clear? Again, let us try the second ordered pair. Okay, here I will make a little change. Instead of writing 5, let me put here 7. And now let us check. Okay, again first ordered pair we will put, so 1 plus 1 is greater than 7, no. So it will not come. Okay, check the second pair, 1 plus 2 greater than 7, no. Second pair will not come. So similarly, you can try all the ordered pairs and check. You will notice that none of the ordered pairs satisfy the given condition. Yes or no, and therefore R will be an empty set because it contains no element of A by A. In other words, we can say there is no A in set A which is related with any element B in set A. Clear? Yes or no? So I hope you have understood this example very well. Let us consider one more example, taking the same set. Okay, a relation defined by S containing ordered pairs A, comma B such that A square is equal to A square is less than minus 1. A belongs to set S. Let me make a little change in this. Okay, now look at this example. Modulus of A minus B less than 0. So now let us check each and every ordered pair. We will put in the formula and check whether the difference, modulus of the difference A minus B is less than 0 or not. So 1 minus 1, that is 0. But 0 is not less than 0. So first ordered pair will not come. Again 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. But modulus of minus 1 is 1, which is greater than 1. So second ordered pair will also not satisfy this condition. Similarly, you will notice that none of the 9 ordered pairs will satisfy this condition. And therefore again, S is an empty relation. Clear? So I hope these two examples are enough for you to understand what is an empty relation or a void relation. Now let us see another type of relation, that is a universal relation. Okay, what is a universal relation? We know that A by A is a subset of A by A. We know that every set is a subset of itself. Therefore, A by A is a subset of A by A, we can write. Okay, and therefore it is a relation from A to itself. Okay, it is called, here A by A is called a universal relation. Clear? In other words, a relation R on set A is universal. A relation R on set A is universal if each element a relation R on set A is universal if each element of set A is related to every element of set A. Let us again go through the definition. A relation R on set A is a universal relation if each element of set A is related to every element of set A. Yes, so no, this is important. One or two examples will make it more clear. So let us see the examples of universal relation. Example 1 for the universal relation. Let us take the same set for our convenience, and again let me write down in order to explain you A cross A elements 1 1 1 2 1 3 2 1 2 2 2 3 and 3 1 3 2 3 3. Okay, these are the elements of A by A. Now I am writing here one relation R containing the ordered pair A comma B such that A minus B is greater than or equal to 0 for AB belongs to set A. Okay, now so far you have understood that the formula is given and R will contain the ordered pairs from A cross A. Yes or no? Now which ordered pairs it will contain from A cross A? Only those ordered pairs which satisfy the given condition. Clear? This is the condition. Okay, so now let us check the first condition. First ordered pair 1 comma 1 and put in the formula 1 minus 1 0. 0 is greater than or equal to 0? Yes. So first ordered pair will be. Now check the second ordered pair 1 minus 2. Now my modulus of 1 minus 2 will be equal to 1, which is greater than 0. Similarly, you will check all the ordered pairs and you will find that all the 9 ordered pairs satisfy the given condition, and therefore R will contain all the 9 ordered pairs. In other words, R is equal to A by A, and therefore you will say that R is a universal relation. Clear? Yes or no? Okay. So I think one example is sufficient for you. Clear? So two types so far we have understood. Number one, void relation or empty relation, and number two, universal relation. Okay, now let us see the third type, that is identity relation. Identity relation, what is an identity relation? Okay, now a relation R on set A is an identity relation if, here by I double F we mean if and only if, each element of that A is related to itself only. Okay, this is an identity relation. A relation R on set A is called an identity relation if each element of a set A is related to itself only. This can be defined in this way. Okay, identity relation on set A. Many times we use the symbol identity relation on set A denoted by IA containing elements A, comma A such that A belongs to A. Clear? Yes or no? Let us see one example. 1, 2, and 3. Okay, and relation I am defining I as a relation, or let me write down R. Okay, containing ordered pairs A, comma B such that A is equal to B and AB belongs to set A. Okay, now obviously from A by A, you will take all the ordered pairs which satisfy the given condition. What is the given condition? A equal to B. So out of the 9 ordered pairs in A by A, we have only 3 ordered pairs in which A is equal to B. Which are those 3 ordered pairs? 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3. So here R will contain only 3 ordered pairs. 1 is related to 1, 2 is related to 2, and 3 is related to 3. So this is an identity relation. In other words, what is an identity relation? Whatever number a given set contains, that many ordered pairs, okay, must be there in R in a given relation. If in set A there are 3 elements, then R will contain 3 ordered pairs, okay, and each element will be related to itself only. Clear? Okay, so now let us see the next type. Reflexive relation. What is a reflexive relation? So reflexive relation is defined in this way. A relation R on set A is reflexive if each element of set A is related to itself, or a relation R on set A is reflexive if for all A belongs to set A, order pairs A, comma A belongs to R. The first definition would be easier to understand. Each element of set A is related to itself. Now this definition is similar to the definition of the identity relation, but there is a little difference if you observe carefully the two definitions. In the identity relations, we define each element of set A is related to itself only. While here, each element of set A is related to itself. There is a difference of the word only. Okay, so what to understand from this difference is that here each element must be paired with itself. This is the minimum required condition. If any other extra pairs are there, then it will do. For example, for a set A containing 3 elements, suppose 1, 3. Okay, so here you have to check that minimum 3 ordered pairs, 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3 must be there. So you notice that here 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3 are there. 1, 3 is an extra pair. It will. Okay, but minimum these 3 pairs must be there, because by definition each element of a given set is related to itself. So 3 elements are there, so minimum 3 ordered pairs must be there. If any other extra pairs are there, it will do. Clear? So this is a reflexive relation. Okay, now similarly we can consider one or two more examples to understand the reflexive relation. Suppose if I write down R2 containing the ordered pairs 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2. Okay, now you will notice that since we have 3 elements in set A, 1, 2 and 3, so minimum 3 ordered pairs 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3 must be there. Here you notice that 1, 1 and 2, 2 are there, but 3, 3, 3, 3 ordered pair, that one ordered pair is missing, and therefore R2 is not reflexive. Clear? Similarly, let us take the third set containing the ordered pairs 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Okay, now look at this carefully. So minimum condition 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3, 3 ordered pairs we have. So minimum condition is satisfied, therefore R3 is reflexive. If you notice that this is an identity relation, yes or no? Because all the identity, this relation contains only identity pairs, and therefore one thing can be concluded, okay, this is reflexive. We will write down. And one conclusion can be made from this that the identity relation is always reflexive. Yes or no? Number one. Okay, then if I take R4 containing all the A by A. Okay, so A by A contains how many elements? 9 elements, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3. 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, and 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3. But for a reflexive relation, we require these 3 ordered pairs. So are these 3 ordered pairs present in A by A? Yes. 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3 are already present in A by A. And therefore, we will say that A by A is reflexive. Okay, so another conclusion can be made from this, that a universal relation is also always reflexive. So two things here, two notes we have to make. I will write down here, then you notice. Number one, an identity relation is always reflexive, and number two, a universal relation is always reflexive. Clear? So identity and universal relations are always reflexive relations. Clear? Now let us move further and see another type. So far we have seen how many types, starting from the void or empty relation, a void relation, then universal relation, then identity relation, and number four is reflexive relation. Now we will see number 5, a symmetric relation. What is a symmetric relation? Let us see. A relation R on set A is symmetric if A comma B belongs to R implies B comma A belongs to R for all AB belongs to set A. Clear? So it is very easy to understand that if you have any order pair A comma B in the relation R, then its reverse pair B comma A must be there in R. And if so, or if this condition is satisfied, then we will say that the given relation is symmetric relation. For example, taking the same set A containing the same elements, I define one or two relations, relation R1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, 3, 1, 2, 1 and 1, 2. Okay, look at this. Recall the definition. If AB belongs to R, then its reverse pair must be there. In other words, what you have to check, you have to find out whether you have the reverse pair for each ordered pair or not. 1, 1, its reverse pair is 1, 1. 2, 2, reverse pair is 2, 2. 1, 3, reverse pair is 3, 1, present. And 2, 1, the reverse pair is 1, 2, it is also present. It means for each pair, we have its reverse pair also present in R1 and therefore it is a symmetric relation. Clear? Now let us consider the another example, R2. Okay, here 1, 1, 2, 3. 2, 2, 3, 2, 1, 5, and 3, 3. Okay, look at the ordered pairs. What we have to check? We have to check the reverse pair for every pair. 1, 1, the reverse pair is 1, 1. 2, 3, the reverse pair is 3, 2, present. 2, 2, reverse pair is 2, 2 itself. 1, 5, the reverse pair is 5, 1, but it is not present if you observe. Okay, so you don't have a reverse pair for 1 comma 5 and therefore we will say that R2 is not symmetric. Clear? So here R2 is not a symmetric relation. Now let us see two more examples for the symmetric relation. Okay, R3, 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3. Now let us check the reverse pair for each pair. Now 1, 1, the reverse pair is 1, 1 itself, 2, 2, reverse pair is 2, 2 itself and 3, 3, reverse pair is 3, 3 itself. So we have reverse pair for every given pair present in R3 and therefore it is symmetric. You have noticed that we have identity pairs, or in other words R3 represents an identity relation. So what is the conclusion? That the identity relation is always symmetric. Previously we concluded that the identity relation is always reflexive. Now we have concluded that identity relation is always symmetric. It means identity relation is always both reflexive as well as symmetric. Okay, this is a symmetric relation here. Okay, now R4, I am taking the universal set. It means all the ordered pairs, all the 9 ordered pairs starting from 1, 1 and ending at 3, 3. Yes or no? 3, 3. So you will notice that A by A contains all the reverse pair for every pair. For example, 1-1, reverse pair is 1-1 only. 1-2, there is 2-1 also present in A by A. So for each and every ordered pair, we have its reverse pair present in A by A, and therefore R4 is also symmetric. And we know that A by A represents a universal relation. So another conclusion is what? That universal relation is always symmetric. Previously we have concluded that universal relation is always reflexive. So now we will say that universal relation is always reflexive as well as symmetric. Clear? So here also you can make notes that an identity relation is always symmetric and a universal relation is always symmetric. An identity relation is always symmetric. A universal relation is always symmetric. Yes, so another type symmetric relations we have seen. Now let us see the next type, and that is transitive relation. Transitive relation. Okay, now let us see what is a transitive relation. Okay, a relation on set A, a relation R on set A is transitive if A, B belongs to R and B, C belongs to R, it implies A, C belongs to R. Okay, this is an important type because here you will have always little bit confusion. Okay, what is this definition? Let us try to understand. If the two ordered pairs are given in R, A, B and B, C, look at the type. The second component of this first ordered pair and the first component of the second ordered pair are common or same. Yes or no? B. So if you have two such pairs like A, B and B, C, then there must be the third ordered pair containing A, C here in R. Then only the given relation is transitive. Clear? So if A, B and B, C belongs to R, then only A, C must be in R. We have to check. But if you don't have, it means another meaning of this definition, another side we need to understand is what? Suppose, what if such two pairs are not there? Then if A, B and B, C type two pairs are not there, then what? So then also the relation is transitive. That I will give you examples to make it clear. Okay, let us take example number one, set A. Same set we will take, and relation R1 I will define as 1, 2, 2, 3, 1 3. Okay, 1 2 2 3. 1 3 we have. Clear. So notice that here A comma B and B comma C are there, such that this in the first order pair 1 comma 2, the second component is 2, and in the second order pair the first component is also 2. So 2 is common. So this is the ordered pair of this type A comma B and B comma C, 1 comma 2 and 2 comma 3. So we must have 1 comma 3 in R1. 1 comma 3 is there, yes, and therefore this relation we will say it is transitive. Clear? So this is an example of a transitive relation. I hope this example is clear. Okay, now let us see the second example. 1 1 2 2 3 3. Now so far you have understood that this is an identity, this set represents an identity relation. Okay, now you have to check the condition that if AB and BC are present, then AC. But first let us check whether ordered pairs of the type AB and BC are present. So you will notice that no two pairs of the form AB and BC are present in the R2, and therefore this is transitive. So this is an important side of this relation, this type of relation. Clear? That if two pairs of type AB and BC are not there, then you don't have to check AC. Okay, in that case the given relation is transitive only. Another example of the same kind I will give. One one and 3 2. So here also you will notice 1 1 3 2 and 3 1. Okay, now look at this R3. Here try to identify the ordered pairs of the form AB and BC. So do you find any ordered pair of the form AB and BC? No. Here you will not find any ordered pair of this type AB and BC, and therefore we don't have to find out AC. Clear? And therefore this is also an example of a transitive relation. Clear? And finally, one more example we can take. A by A. Now obviously A by A will contain all the pairs of A by A. Yes or no? A by A means all the pairs, all the 9 pairs are there, and in which you will find all the pairs of the type AB, BC, then AC. Clear? And therefore this is also always transitive. Okay, so identity relation and universal relations are always transitive. Clear? So let us note down this fact that an identity relation and a reflexive relation, a universal relation, are always transitive. So in one point only I will write down this identity relation and a reflexive relation are universal, not reflexive, but universal relation are always transitive. Clear? So far we have understood that identity and universal relation are reflexive as well as symmetric as well as transitive. Clear? So now these last three types we have seen: reflexive relation, symmetric relation and transitive relation. Now any relation if you can have any relation which satisfy all the three conditions, reflexivity, symmetricity and transitivity, then such a relation is called an equivalence relation. So this is another type of relation, equivalence relation. Let us see that. Equivalence relation a relation R on set A is an equivalence relation if number one, A comma A belongs to R for all A belongs to set A, number two, A comma B belongs to R implies B comma A belongs to R for all AB belongs to set A, and number 3, A comma B belongs to R and B comma C belongs to R implies A comma C belongs to R for all A, B and C belongs to set A. Okay, so if a relation R is reflexive, this is the definition of reflexivity, symmetric as well as transitive, then such a relation is called the equivalence relation. A relation R on set A is equivalent if it satisfies the following conditions. Clear? And the three conditions are reflexivity, symmetricity and transitivity. So a relation which is all these three is also an equivalence relation. Clear? Okay, now let us see the equivalence classes. What is an equivalence class? Okay, if R is an equivalence relation on set A, if R is an equivalence relation on set A, then a set containing all A belongs to set A, all X belongs to set A, such that then a set containing X, all X belongs to A such that X comma A belongs to R for A belongs to set A. Clear? Yes or no? So equivalence class related to element A. Okay, this is the definition of an equivalence class. Okay, we can define this like this. Equivalence class for A is given by to represent the equivalence class of element A. Clear? Remember that A is the image. Yes or no? Or we can say that A is the second component here, and all the elements which are related to second component, okay, the set containing all those elements will give you the equivalence class related to that particular second component. Clear? You can understand this fact with the help of example. So in the exercise, we will see when we will find the equivalence classes related to any element if given. Okay, we can check. Or let us check one example of an equivalence relation now only, and we will find out the equivalence classes related to a particular element. Okay, example. Let us consider set A containing elements 1, 2, 3, and an equivalence relation is defined symmetricity, reflexivity, three ordered pairs we have. Okay, symmetricity, reverse pairs 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, and 1, 3, 3, 1 we have. Clear? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, all the 9 ordered pairs we have written, so it is A cross A only. So it is equivalence only, because this is, this set is A by A. Yes or no? Because in A by A we have 9 pairs. Clear? So this is an equivalence relation, because this is all reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Now we have to, suppose we have to find the equivalence class related to 1. Okay, so you will find out all the elements in which the second component is 1. So look at this, here 1, okay, and another element containing, okay, this one and this one. Clear? So we have three ordered pairs in which the second component is 1. So now we can make a set, okay, of the elements which are related to 1. So here 1, 2 and 3. Clear? So this is an equivalence class related to 1. I hope you have understood. This example will make you clear what is an equivalence class. Similarly, you can find out equivalence class related to element 2 or 3. Obviously, you will get the same element 1, 2, 3 only. Clear? So far, we have seen today what is a relation and various types of relations. One more type is left over there, antisymmetric relation. Okay, so let us see that type and then we will just revise all the types. Symmetric relation. Okay, this type may be useful for the competitive exams, but in the NCERT syllabus this is not included. Remember one thing. Okay, what is an antisymmetric relation? A relation R on set A is antisymmetric if A comma B belongs to R and B comma A belongs to R, double implies A is equal to B. So if you have ordered pair A comma B and its reverse pairs B comma A, it means these two pairs are possible only in the case A is equal to B. In simple words, if we try to understand that, you don't have for any reverse pair, you must not have its reverse pair present in the given relation. Then only accept the identity pairs. Okay, only identity pairs are valid. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. If we take the set, for example, if we take the set containing elements 1, 2, 3 and the relation 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Okay, and let us take one more element 1, 3. Okay, so except the three identity pairs, we have one more pair 1 comma 3, so its ordered pair must not be present. Okay, in that case this is an anti-symmetric relation. Clear? So today we started with the definition of relation, number of relations, okay, that can be defined on set A, then various types of relations starting from the void relation, then universal relation, identity relation, then reflexive, symmetric, transitive, equivalence and anti-symmetric relation we have seen. Clear? Okay, so all the type of relation we have seen, and one more final type we will see, inverse relation, that we will define from set A to B. Yes or no? For set, a relation from set A to B, we will define its inverse. Inverse relation. Okay, if R is a relation from set A to set B, then its inverse, or then a relation from set B to set A is called the inverse of relation R, denoted by R inverse. Clear? So if R is a relation from set A to set B, then R inverse is a relation from set B to set A. It is called the inverse relation of relation R. So obviously, in R, the elements will come from A by B, and while in R inverse, the elements will be from B by A. Clear? Okay, what are domain and range of the relation? We know the domain of a relation is a set containing all the first components of the ordered pairs of R. Let us quickly discuss this. However, we have seen this in the 11th standard. Okay, domain set containing all first components, okay, and range is a set containing all second components. Clear? And for inverse relation, for a relation R, domain of R is equal to range of R inverse and range of R is equal to domain of R inverse. Clear? So you will remember this fact. With this, the explanation of this particular topic, relations, is over. All the types of relation, what is a relation, domain, range of relation, various types of relation, we have explained in this class. I hope you have understood this all the terms very well. In the next video, we will solve the textbook exercise, okay, on the basis of relations. Clear? Thank you very much.